is we're going to, let's say we're done with our weights and we're happy with what they look like in your body. You're not done with your weights until this arm looks like your body, your arm moving in real life. That is your goal. Does everybody understand that? That is the goal. So if it doesn't look like that, you're not done. So what we're going to do is we're going to set up this using PSAs for the hand and something a little bit different for the arm. And I'm going to end up, once we get to the full rigs, I'm going to give you the controls that you're going to use. You're not going to create them. But for this, we're just going to use NURBS circles. However, remember, delete your history on your NURBS circle and freeze your transformations. That is something that some of you guys are having a hard time doing. Some of this is going to be overkill. Okay. And then we're actually doing this. Our placement. Constraint, if you do not have maintained offset, safety for the elbow. I'm going to hit G. That's G's last tool. We're not done with the elbow yet. Just a little heads up. We're going to do the same thing for the forearm. Select the control, select the joint. And then the rest is the same thing. Select the control, select the joint. There we go. So that. Now, forearm control. Actually, I'm going to do something different for the forearm. Delete this one. Sorry. So we have this one here. Cool. And then for the forearm, I'm just going to take this. And which rotation do I want? Looks like I'm going to want X. So I'm going to go here. Constrain. Orient. So for this one, I'm not going to do orient constraint. I'm going to do something else. But we have this. We have this. And we have this. Now, for the forearm, we're going to have to go into the... I'm going to connect my rotate X. Look at it. X is kind of going this way. We're going to connect rotate X same thing, which is what we don't want. So the way we're going to fix that in the multiply and divide node, I'm going to turn this to negative 1. And now it rotates in that direction. Negative 1. And if I need to, I can always go back and change my multiply and divide node. And let's say negative 1 is too much. Let's say I want to do negative 0.5. So it's a little bit less. I can do that too. Alright. So now that we have these here, what we're going to do is now we got to get our elbows working. So if I rotate this, let's say if I rotate this here, these rotations all change, this rotates, and this rotates. However, for argument's sake, if I was just to take this to here and make that a orient constraint, sorry. Oh. And did the same thing to this one. It will bend, but it's not going to give me the curve that I'm looking for. It's just going to be a straight line. And what I want is for that elbow section to be a little bit of a curve. So, let's see what we can do. Let's see what happens when I go into the connection editor and take this joint. And so we load in elbow 1, and then I load as my, what we're going to go from, and then elbow 2 to where I'm going to, and I go rotate to rotate. Then we select this one, and we go rotate. Now I'm getting that bend that I want. So I can't use a straight orient constraint for everything because it's not going to give me what I'm looking for. But if I use that in conjunction with using the connection editor, I can get that nice bend because your elbow, it's made up of a couple of parts, and we're trying to replicate that to a certain degree. Does everybody understand that? Now, can I create an elbow with just one joint? Yes, I've already discussed that last class. I like using three, but you can